In this video, we're going to go over how to use the RAND and RAND between formulas. Now, the RAND and RAND between formulas are used in Excel to either create a random number or to choose a random number from within a list. So, for example, if you type in equals RAND, open and close parentheses, that's just your basic random formula. When you hit enter, Excel will generate for you a random number that's greater than zero, less than one. So it'll always be a decimal point. And just know that this number is dynamic. So anytime you type anything else or you do anything on the sheet, it'll continue to refresh. So if we just type in the number one, it refreshes. If we delete the number one, it refreshes again. So the formula is constantly changing. If you want this to become static, the only thing you can really do is copy it and then paste it as values. And by the way, this little paste option with the 1, 2, 3, that's your paste as values option. It gets rid of any formulas and just keeps whatever is in the cell as your static result. So RAND between lets Excel choose a random number from within a list. So if you use RAND between, you would use your bottom number. We can just say 1, top number is 100, and the result will be something, a number between 1 and 100. In this case, it's 61. Now, this is also a dynamic formula, so you'll see that it changes every time you do anything to the sheet. What's also different about this formula is if the result is a whole number, so it's not going to be a decimal point. And to make the static again, you would do the same thing. You would copy, paste as values, and then it refreshes again one last time. But you see that now up here in the formula bar, your formula is gone and it's the cell now just reads 21. So some practical uses for this. Let's say, for example, we want to create product numbers. Delete this. One thing you could do is use the RAND formula to generate random numbers for each of our product names here. And this list is from another video that I did on creating bingo sheets, by the way. So as a side note, if you'd like to learn how to do that at home, please do make sure to watch that video. But once we've generated random numbers here, we can just highlight those, copy them, and paste them as values. Now, problem is if we want random numbers, ideally we don't want them to be decimal numbers. I mean, I guess really it doesn't matter, but most people would like product numbers to be a bit bigger. So once you have this, all you could do is really say equals times a bigger number. So let's just say 100,000 for argument's sake. And you see how now we have more respectably sized numbers as our product numbers. Now it's still a little bit weird because it's got decimal points. And as you can see, if we expand that, the decimal points just keep going and going. So we don't want that. So to clean that up, you could just highlight everything, go into data, text to columns, keep delimited. Oh, actually, hang on, before we do this, we'll wanna make sure these are also whole numbers and not, or static numbers and not formulas. So we'll want to also paste those as values. So now we can highlight, we're in data, text to columns, delimited, next, choose other, because we're not using tab, semicolon, comma, any of those, and just make sure your decimal point is in this box, and choose finish. We can delete this, and you see how the decimals are still there, but now they're all zeros. So that this is just formatting. As far as Excel is concerned, up here, there is nothing behind these. So now we can just have cleaner numbers, go back to home, get rid of all this whole numbers as your product number for each one. So that's one thing you could do with the RAND formula. You could also use it to assign random numbers to a list and resort and just do a number of things by generating your own random number that you could assign to as an identifier. So a practical use of the RAND between formula, it's let's say from this list we want to pick a winner. So we know the list is from 1 to 10, so we could say equals RAND between 1 and 10, and our winning product is 7, which in this case is the bride. Now, something else we could do to actually get back the product name rather than the number is create an index. Now, an index is basically a list that you'll create for Excel to choose a result from. So you could type equals index, and we'll want to choose the same product list that we had from before, and then RAND between. And we know that the list goes from 1 to 10. So our bottom number is 1, our top number is 10. And we would have two parentheses, two close parentheses to finalize our result. And in this case, when we bring it back using the index, it chooses Vail as the winner. So it's a little bit different. This one is RAND between 1 and 10, and you can see it also went dynamic and changed when we chose Vail. And Vail is choosing from this list. So it's different ways that you can use these formulas in a more practical sense. So anyways, I hope this video was useful to you in figuring out ways that you could use RAND and RAND between formulas in your different tasks. And if you enjoyed it, please do make sure to like and subscribe to the video. Thanks.